issues at all. I still decided to do a second one since you can see how much growth has happened in a month. It's also, I guess I will always have the stats on the YouTube page to see, look back on, but it's also just a kind of nice memory, and just doing this video makes me really realize how much I've grown, so I like to do that, and maybe people will be more interested now that the numbers have grown, and I hope this one will be in comparison to last month, and the other one, there was no comparison since it was the first month. So this time I'm doing it a bit less days, so it's from the 9th to the 8th of August, which is like 31 days, I believe, and the other time it was a few more, so just a month. I was going to do 8th to 8th, but then I realized that if I do include the 8th, then I'm using that twice, because last time it was still the 8th. So we can see this page and how many views I've gotten and whatever. So last month it was 1k views, and this month it is 9.7k views, or 9,695. And watch time hours last month was 108.7. This month, 1,500. Wow. Last month, plus 23 subs. This month, plus 261 subs. And that's absolutely crazy to me. Thank you so much if you subscribed in this month. So in this month, you've got a quarter to the 1,000 watch, the 1,000 subscribers you need. And more than a quarter of the watch time hours you need to be monetized. So that's absolutely crazy for me. It seems insight. It's still a bit to go, but insight. It's never seemed like that before when I was doing my other channel for a bit. So yeah, that's crazy. I haven't really planned exactly what I'm going to talk about, but yeah. So currently I have 288 subscribers total. And yeah, you can kind of just see the top content in the past 48 hours. Here it's a bit lower, 834. But because over the weekend, or not just the weekend, like Sunday, Monday, it was very high. It was at like 1,200 in the past 28 hours and stuff. So especially, I've had another milestone, is that I've reached 2 days in a row, or just at over 100 watch time hours a day. So Sunday and then Monday. Got over 100. So at the start of the month, you can kind of see, I think every single day there was at least 10 watch time hours. So it starts kind of low, and I thought, well, it was high for me. 12, 18, 19, that was high. And then I reached a peak, 47.8, and I was so excited about that. Then it went down to 24, 38, 23, 56, 25, 36, 50, and then 50 kind of became like the norm. Kind of 40, 50, and then I got a high of 60, and then 70, and that was crazy for me. And then it was like slowly, you know, it's not getting back down there, it's now, this is kind of the norm up here, and then it's going up, and then down here, and now even higher is becoming kind of the norm, or what's usual. Usually it kind of goes up to one, then it goes to, when it kind of recalculates about one watch time hour, sometimes it goes down up to one watch time hour. So from yesterday it's 67, and you can see when I film this video, I have other lots of videos filmed, so I might put this one up later, but then again, because this is like a date orientated thing, I might try to put it closer to when I actually filmed this. Likewise, I also filmed a workout video, but I haven't been able to upload that because on some of the runs and walks and stuff, it says where I live, and I don't want it. And then also it has a map, so I'm kind of blurring that out, and it was really long that I was talking for, so it's a lot to blur out. And it's not just, it's that when I scroll down, it moves, so then I have to move the blur, so it's really time consuming, so I'm not sure if I'll ever actually post that, but we'll see. And if so, it's about August, so, you know, who knows when it will be actually published. But yeah, also sorry for the background, it's not the majority of the video, the majority is the screen, but yeah, it's just the webcam, so you can kind of just see the top in the last 48 hours and whatever, so I can see my top in this period, in which is the month, and oops, that was not meant to happen, but yeah, whatever, I'm in here now, this is my top video, 1,000. was published, and it was published, I think if it down here at the 28th of August, so 29, 30, 31, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, so like a week and 2 days ago. And yeah, 1,450 views, 223 watch time hours. You can see like a big in there. Like at that time I got like 40 hours or something in a day from this video, watch time hours. And 59 subscribers just from this, so it's crazy. When I started doing true crime, I really noticed an increase in people subscribing and just commenting and views in general. So 30.4k impressions, that's absolutely crazy. That's when people were showing the video and they were showing the thumbnail and had to choose if they wanted to watch or not. So 3.9 click-through rate. And yeah, it's crazy, absolutely crazy. So also you can see how people found this. So YouTube recommendations, is YouTube whole, YouTube recommendations is 54.5%, which is 790 views. So it really helps if YouTube likes you and starts recommending you. I think YouTube can like make or break video basically, because sometimes when you see that the views aren't that high or whatever else, you're like, what happened? And then you look and the impressions aren't that high, which means YouTube isn't showing your thumbnail to potential viewers. So if they're not showing the thumbnail, how are they going to know to watch it? As well, I mean, except if they like search for something related to that. But search is also, but like, so there was some videos where the impressions was really low, and I think it's just that like after a while, maybe the people that watched it didn't like it, or they clicked away quickly. So YouTube decided it wasn't a good video, and those flop then, you know. So I was saying like it can really weather YouTube. They decide quite quickly if they're gonna start recommending it and if it can do well. So I'm not the expert, of course, in the whole algorithm. People have done videos on it, but like the whole point is it's meant to be secret and it's meant to not be like straightforward. You're not meant to be able to, you know, figure it out. But either way, it's a really helpful. So thank you, YouTube, for all the recommendations. Probably like half the views and watch time is from YouTube recommending, you know. So other than its search features, it's because like 500 views from search features, 34.6% of views. I think it's because as well I'm doing videos that people are searching for. So true crime ASMR, I might title the video like, as you can probably see here, yeah, true crime ASMR, and then I put the name. So that doesn't mean people are searching for that particular case, because that would like, you know, I don't think 500 people in the span of 9 days would be searching specifically that case for ASMR, but they would search true crime ASMR and this would pop up. So yeah, people are searching true crime ASMR, so I always do true crime ASMR, that little like symbol, I don't know exactly what it's called, and then the case name. So yeah, and then we just have some of the channel pages. I think that just means like they pick from your page, so they on your profile or your channel. Other YouTube readers, that's just other, and I guess you can see all if you want. You can kind of see graphs and stuff. Playlists, that's either other people's playlists that they've made and put me in, so that could be their own personal one or one they just put public on their channel. So or it could be I've made a playlist on true crime, because apparently, no, oh, playlist page, that could be my playlist page, and that could be their playlist, I'm not sure, honestly. So notifications as well, as people are subscribed and they put on their notifications. So yeah, that's just a little look into it. So I don't want to spend all the time on this one video. I'm not going to go into every video because I've done so many videos this month. This is my next most popular video. It's nearly at 170.9 watch time hours and 31 subscribers. So this video is interesting. saying, because they can obviously see the comments that people are putting, that I'm not talking too fast. It just kind of depends, like, where you're from. So if English is like your second language, maybe it's too fast. Or if you're from a culture where people talk slower, even if English is your first language, then maybe that's too fast. But I don't know. I try to keep in mind, but not everyone has says this. And when you think about it, I've got 31 subscribers. This is my second most popular video, and it's the one I've got some comments that I'm talking too fast. And it seems like a lot of people are saying this, but in reality, it's 4 or 5 people out of all the people that watched it that commented that. I guess people could have thought it and didn't comment it, but still, people are still liking it and all this, all the rest. And I never advertised that I talked, that it's a slow talking video, or, you know, it's kind of like, this is my pace. Maybe I'm talking slower now because I'm not reading as well. I tend to like start to read faster when I'm reading from a list, which I tend to be doing a lot. Like, this was a facts video in English, of course. I just posted the day I filmed this. I just posted, if I posted later this video, then it might not just been posted. But I posted reading Harry Potter in 4 languages. So of course, when I was reading in Irish, German, and French, I talk slower. That really sped up when I started talking in English. But you know, just as in, it might be fast for your culture, this may be normal for my culture, you know, or whatever. Or I just could be talking fast. Can be dependent as well. I guess with foreign language as well, you know. Of course, I think I used to live in France. Like, I thought French people would talk really fast. Like, Spanish people would talk really fast. Of course, when you don't understand the language well, I'm not saying people that think it's too fast is their second language. It could be your first, whatever. I'm just saying I do make a conscious effort to slow down a bit, but sometimes I forget, you know. And yeah, thank you for the nice comments, and it makes me think of how I'm talking or whatever. But you know, as well, it's not nice to be rude about anything, you know. We all speak differently. And yeah, you can see the top geographies, the not subscribed versus subscribed. So if you haven't, please subscribe. It depends. That's just for this video. The percentage is a bit lower. I mean, higher subscribed usually. But yeah, and what's another statistic which is interesting? Oh, sorry, I went out of that. Is like the how long people watched for. So when they clicked off, and that's an average, so 10 minutes 20. And when it's green, it's like the more than usual. If there's just a tick that's not green, it's like about the same. And if it's down, it's lower. So yeah, we'll just keep going. That was, yeah, this was a really popular one, the part 2 of this one. Yeah, it was the Emma the Asshole. That was a popular, and that was the most popular out of them all, I believe. That was my most popular video for a while before the true crime one. And then that one, like, shot up, you know. And this one, the random facts one, was kind of random that it was most popular. True crime. And when this percentage is like, what percentage of the video did they click off? Like, that's like, I think they watched 20% of the video and stuff. That one is a kind of a random one. It's also a random facts one, but it's a lot more popular than some of the other ones. I don't know why, honestly. But it's just how it goes. I've got a few ones that have 100 watch time. That one is a really popular one as well. Like, you can see some of them have more views than the other ones, but they don't have as much watch time. This one was interesting because at first it wasn't too popular, but then there was like, as you can probably see, a big like thing. So that was like 3 days into it. And then also 4 days, is that like a good amount more? So sometimes there's a, you know, a big thing like that. And I was curious why that at first wasn't doing too well, because that's a quite popular thing, asking people questions. It's kind of like a role play, like you're kind of in character, not the whole time, kind of. Like, I don't think I did my, I'm not podcast list, it's all my true crimes except the Hinta Kaifak murders. But yeah, and I believe, no, it's not this one, it's the other one. I had just posted, this is part one that was already posted for a few days when I did the last video. So now we're gonna go into this area content. And we're gonna go to all. Oh, wait, no, we're gonna see first. So, yeah, 222.3k impressions. The click through rate is 3.4, and the average view duration is 9 minutes 19. That's about normal, I think, around an average is 3%. That's a lot of impressions, but it seems like a lot anyway. So now we can kind of see how much content I published. 28. Videos, and it's actually 29. Well, we're going until the 8th, so I published one yesterday, which was like the I published it this morning, which is technically the night goes after midnight, so it's not counting, but yeah, 28, and that's considering how many days there are in a month. There are around 31 days. That's an early one every day. I missed one day because I don't know, one of the days, it's more in my memory because it was more recently. Before that, it was a good while ago. I can't remember what it was. I think it could have been because I started editing a good bit, the TikTok kind of viral one, and that took a longer time to edit because, like, all the, you have to go through all the cuts of all the footage and stuff. To the voiceover afterwards and all that. So I did like 4 shorts, I believe, but they didn't do that well. I didn't want to do an extra thing, so I didn't focus on shorts when I was doing my other channel. The main kind of focus was a lot of shorts because those were the ones I was getting subscribers from. But you know, in this, I'm getting subscribers just from like videos itself, so I don't really need to do that really. So yeah, we can see the impressions. This is also an interesting thing, the browse features. YouTube search suggested videos. What also confused me at first was it's under different names. If you go into the individual, it's under like suggested video. But if browse features, that kind of sounds like search, but that's search because browsing. But 31.4%, and if you go on here, it gives you a little explanation. It says traffic from the homepage / home screen, the subscription feed, and other browsing features. So it can also be your subscription feed, which doesn't get that many, like 10 a video max, maybe, depending. More as you grow, more other browsing features, or at least for me, it was like that. Other browsing features, I'm not sure what that is, but the main thing to note here is traffic from the homepage / home screen. So that's when YouTube recommends you on the homepage or the home screen. So that's similar to suggested videos, but suggested videos is only views from suggestions appearing alongside or after other videos. So you know, when you've seen the videos on the side, if you click one from there or after your video and you go on to watch it, that's what's counted here. So they're separated, the home versus like up next kind of thing. So that searches remains really important. How you title your video is important, and to do videos that people are searching for. So for me, that has been true crime, am I the asshole, and facts videos. Those are kind of the basic kind of videos that I've been doing. I've done a lot of am I the asshole ones, I've done 5 at this stage, but I'm not sure because like they were getting really popular, but now my latest one didn't get as many views, so I'm not sure why they're good to continue doing them. I've tried other or kind of things people seem to search for, am I the asshole, like AIDA. I've tried done an or confessions one from an article, but it wasn't as popular. It's okay. And that the first one I did, the first video I think was or no sleep, and didn't get that many views, but I didn't get that many impressions either, so maybe if I did another one it would do well. True crime, it just takes a bit longer to plan. And facts, I've done lots of facts videos now at this stage, I don't know how many, but I did it with 3-part series, and I think verse, I'm not sure. And then after the pop culture verses, food one, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, at least 9, I believe, so far. Could be more. So people really search for facts and stuff like that, and it's good because they're easy to do. You either just find a list online or get AI. I think I keep talking about it, but I think AI is really helpful for ASMR. I want to do a video where like AI controls like my ASMR, like roleplay kind of thing, but we'll see. I haven't, well that's the other thing, I really want to kind of do more roleplays and stuff like that. The only thing is like you have to write out the whole script and kind of know it beforehand, because you don't want to kind of just be reading for that. The other ones like facts and things, the whole point is to kind of read facts, you don't need to memorize them. The true crime, it's a bit of a like whatever kind of thing, like you could know them better. I feel like a lot of people know what they're talking about when they do these videos, but honestly in my one so far I haven't taken the extra time to, you know, learn it off by heart. Instead, because like everything that you do takes time, I could spend an hour and know it really well, but then I maybe prefer to spend that hour researching the next one, you know, then I get another one out sooner. Just depends how you want to spend the time. What else? Oh yeah, so a lot of them are kind of similar, like the personal questions kind of thing. That's just, I found a list. The only difference is I look at the camera and do the write down thing, so I point the mic down. So, and to write, I'm not really writing anything, it's kind of nonsense. Or what I think they'd say. But, what was I gonna say? That, you don't have to memorize for that either, because you just read the question, you look at the screen quickly, read the question, and then ask it to the camera. And it's just like a one-line question, so it's easy to remember, you know? So, yeah, I'm just gonna see it, some other things. I'm not, videos, growing your audience. I'm not really sure how important this is. It's like new viewers have returned. I think that means like they returned and then watch more videos, not to the same video. So it's like people from the true crime ones, the first 3 year, it's kind of like dark, but for the first 3 they kind of returned. Also reading facts, stuff like that, so people returned. And or, but like this one's low, it means they kind of just watched that one and didn't watch any more. This stat I thought was kind of useful, but I'm not really using it too much. It's when your viewers are online. So on the other channel, I didn't actually see this at all. I think it's more to do with watch time than subscribers, because you need a good amount of watch time for YouTube to calculate this. So it kind of just tells you based on when they're active, what time to upload. And for some people, it's kind of earlier in the day, because it's ASMR, the most active time is at night. So it's kind of like telling you to upload before or just when everyone's online, so they'll get your video starting to get views straight away. So for me, it does, it has recalculated a few times, but it's always been between 8 and 10 p.m. There was a few that were 8 p.m. and then changed to 9 p.m. So now Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, 9 p.m., Wednesday, 9 p.m., and then 3 days, 10 p.m. I kind of just upload whenever it's ready. Sometimes it's 1:30 a.m., you know. Hopefully not. Here it says published time is not known to directly affect the long-term performance of a video, and I also did some research on this, kind of just read it, not a very reliable sources necessarily, but I did research on this because, you know, if published time were to affect how your video did, it might be important to consider, you know, doing your videos towards the published time. It tells you either just doing them and uploading them in, or, you know, you can schedule your videos. And the thing is, if it's, my kind of conclusion was that long-term success isn't affected, it's just short-term success. So what I mean by that is short-term success is just like first few hours or something. So if people are online, your people that watch your videos are online, and then they either search for something, or this is recommended to you, to them, or whole schedule to do this. Like, I should have them ready to be uploaded about this time anyway, but sometimes it's a bit later just because with the green screen and stuff, it takes like 40, 50 minutes to render, so I just render it while I'm watching some TV or something. So then we can also see the watch time from subscribers. So 77.4% is our subscribed, and 22.6% is subscribed. So thank you so much if you're subscribed, and if you haven't already, make sure to do that. The geography is kind of just if you're curious, 34.5% US, 13.7% UK, 2.3% Canada, 2.7% Australia, 1.6% Germany. So sorry if there are any Germans watching that watched my Harry Potter video. Sorry about that. Sweden, 12.4%, 7.9%. Ireland, 7.9%, sorry. It's kind of funny because I swear sometimes I've watched a few of my videos. So I've always wondered if YouTube, like, takes out the watch time hours that you have watched. Because I've watched, like, say, my Harry Potter video that weren't getting a lot of views. Like, the, like, play Harry Potter game with me a few times. Like, there were, like, 11 watch time hours and that one. I feel like it was mostly me. But I feel like that should reflect in the Irish watch time. That's what I swear. She doesn't do it that much because I do so many. But, and, yeah, my mom watches a bit, I swear, as well. And so I feel like the Irish one's a bit higher, but oh well. So, female, male is kind of equal, 53.9 female to 46.2. And the ages are going up. It's mainly, like, 18 to 24, 25 to 34 is the majority, and then 35 to 44. So kind of in and about my age is the majority, ish. and close to that. But still, like, it's between 18 and 44 is still a big gap of years. If people use subtitles or not. And this is all, yeah, this is an interesting one. Kind of like channels that your audience watches. And I don't actually really watch any of these channels. Or Pamela is more just a lot of facts, kind of whispery things. Leah whispers all these. So what's interesting is that a lot of these are smaller channels as well, like not as small as mine, but still small-ish in the like realm of ASMR. Like if we're including like GB and Gracie Gay and Nanu, that all have like over a million. GB well over a million. It's still relatively small. Maybe some people like listening to smaller channels because, you know, it's nice to support smaller channels. I like to find different smaller channels. Depends what we mean by small. Mine is quite small at the moment. But I'm still counting the realm in the under 10k or 10 to 20k small channels, you know, compared to people that have millions. And here the research, your viewer searches, is kind of, I think, the search they got that made you find your video. So ASMR roleplay, ASMR reading, ASMR sleep. It's funny because I don't really have a lot of roleplays, but I'm not necessarily sure if that's what led to views on my video or what else they're searching for, like what I should do next, which I should do roleplay, I know. It's just that scripting them. So my travel ASMR, I can show you, it's a bit down, that one, travel agent whispering. So I got 10 likes on that one, 33 views, 23 watch time hours. It is still going up. Like the other day, it was 20, like yesterday morning. So people are still watching. So thank you if you have. Please watch this if you haven't. But I spent like 5 hours writing that script in like Studio Binder, which is like a script writing software for like written film, TV scripts and stuff, just a free one. You can use it for free. The only thing is that you can only have one project. So what I do is just have multiple scripts in the same project. If you're going to go professional, maybe it's not the best to do that anymore, but I'm sure there's another free one you could use. I just had experience or used that before. But, it, you know, writing out that whole thing took a while. So, like, I just kind of searched roleplays. I think I got the idea from Sophie, Michelle ASMR, and some other person. Kind of watched theirs a bit for some inspiration, kind of what would happen in roleplay. So like, then it was just like someone who wanted to go on holiday and you helped them book the holiday. So what I did is that I actually, like, it's kind of accurate information in that just going through Skyscanner, going through how much the bag would cost and everything. So at first I was like, oh, thinking like, oh, this is really affordable flight, but then I forgot, or I haven't tried to book a flight since Ryanair has changed its bag policy. So it used to be that the cabin bag, or the one you bring on board, like the in the overhead, is included in the ticket price. So, and it's kind of big, so it's like 8 kilos or something. So you could just, I could bring my little suitcase and be good to go on like a short week holiday or whatever, but even longer. But then they changed it, so it's more expensive for the cabin bag than it is for the carry-on now. No, not the cabin, sorry. I think the cabin bag, I think they're actually the same thing. Check-in bag. It's more expensive for the carry-on than it is for the check-in, because I think the check-in could get lost. So I did the whole thing, research all the hotels, were like real hotels, and there were the real prices, and I looked distances and things like that. I looked the taxi and the bus routes for all the bus things I mentioned. So it's all like factual, because I don't want to actually just make it up. Like I could have, but I just don't. It would take longer for me to make it up than just research and stuff. So it's not the research took so long, just writing the whole script word for word. And then I was trying not to look at it the whole time, so not everything is like on the script. But I still had to look at the script a good bit. But like, you know, it was also helpful because, you know, when it's like, oh, let me search that up for you, like when someone's booking their holiday, your holiday, they don't have it all memorized themselves. They're also looking up as they go along. So, you know, it's tap, 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 tap. And I was like, really just looking at the script I wrote, but, you know, little secrets there, but of course it's kind of obvious. But yeah, I don't want to go on to every video. I just know the kind of least popular videos were this kind of video, the stats one. So let's try and change this around and make this most popular video now. Stats, kind of the play with me ones weren't that popular, which is a bit sad because those were fun, just playing games. I also got copyrighted on the CNET one because of the TV scenes. I thought it was the music at first, so I might have like taken the music out, but the thing is, it wasn't just the music, it was also the copyright was from the movie, so it was the scenes that were copyrighted. Okay, what else? Oh, the Duolingo one was not popular. I would have done a part two. It has sometimes, like, it's confusing. Like, it has 188 views there. And, but the watch time is quite low. Well, it's not that low. It's 16.6. I might do a second one. But there's kind of no point doing ones that I know are less popular unless I give them a fair chance. I give them at least two tries. Like, I've done two gaming ones. So I'm going to do two stats ones for released. I should do a second roleplay, I know. I've been watching that. Next one's coming soon. I think I can say that now because I think I'll publish this one. This is going to be today's one because it's stats. It's related to today. But it's just, I said, like, someone commented saying, if this is you, now you know what happened. I said I filmed it today and it's probably coming today, but it is. I filmed it and then I thought I was going to do three videos today, but I did two. I didn't realize how long it was because I was in the sitting room for quite a while filming. But I was like, you know what, like, maybe it just seemed like longer. I stopped and started it a few times, whatever. But then I looked, I went into the editor after, so I went to the beach, to walk to the beach, go for a swim, like, dry a bit, you know, then walk back, do all that. Then I had to actually cook some dinner because there wasn't that many leftovers, so I had to cook a bit. By the time I got to edit, it was after 10 p.m. So I actually looked at how long the show one was, and the last one was like 51 minutes or so. So I was like, maybe about that time. It was 1 hour 16 before I edited. And I'm like, man, that's crazy. Like, when I edit, I have to listen all the way through. For just if I do a cough or something that I want to edit out, or bodily noises or something interrupts, whatever. So I have to kind of listen all the way in. I don't edit out like ums and stuff like that. When I restart something like one time, I don't really do it unless I've kind of made a mistake a few times and then totally restart the sentence. So I've set myself up in editing so I can take out the first attempt. If I just do it very quickly, like, hello, no, like, let's say my name is, I might not bother with that, you know. Sometimes like trying to edit something that's quick like that might actually look more choppy edited out than leaving it in. Either way, I'm not perfect about it, but just, you do have to listen all the way through, so that's like a half an hour extra of listening. Well, 5 minutes, 36 minutes extra of listening of my 40 minute video. So I was like, not today, not today. So that's why it will be coming soon though. If you have any other ideas for me, let me know. I don't really know what to say in this exactly, but seen videos about doing playlist boosts your watch time, and of course my watch time has been going up, but I don't think playlists are really that much of a factor overall. I don't know when this reset actually, sorry guys. I think it's when you like refresh it. So anything I said could be wrong, because it's meant to be 40 minutes. I feel like I talked about enough stuff. I've got a lot of comments as well. Sometimes I just forget that I've gotten a comment or gotten so many comments, but I've gotten at least like 50 probably plus comments, and like I kind of always forget like how many people it's been and stuff and whatever. And even just doing as I do this video, my views are going up or whatever. I kind of just popular, and also using AI to generate facts, ideas, and whatever I can. I've messed around with AI, as I probably said in a previous video, and I tried to get it to write a roleplay script for me. If I could get AI to write roleplay scripts, I'd probably do so many more, because it takes so long to write, but they're not really that long. But what is good is that it was giving me good scripts, good outlines for scripts. So like the ASMR, I was thinking of doing like an ASMR sleep clinic one, and it was giving me a good outline. It was also telling me when I asked it to like a certain like instructions for like certain like what not to do if you want to sleep, like avoid blue light, avoid like screens before bed, that's blue light, but all of that stuff. And it was saying like spend whatever amount of words on that, and it was giving me like a kind of outline, orders like check-in, receptionist, you know, it was like quite good. So I think there's a real potential for, if you have an ASMR channel, keep this in mind, a real potential for using AI to outline your role plays, but then be able to write them yourself. So it's really good, because AI is such a thing now to harness that, to like make you, help you think of ideas and all that. It also gives you ideas for interactive escape room kind of things, which I thought would be so cool. And for that, it literally wrote my whole thing for doing that, like the different clues. And I was like, okay, give me the clues or riddles, and it would give me them all and stuff. It's just, it was kind of hard to implement. It was like interactive experience, but how do you have an interactive ASMR experience, you know? This isn't actually an escape room, you know, so it was kind of hard to actually implement. It's kind of a bit complicated, and we'll see. But I want to try new things, especially if I get bored. I just, so far, I know the language videos don't do that well. Not that high for me. At least, maybe if I was learning another language, maybe. And as well, what don't do that well? The stats one, the gameplay stuff like that. But what does well is the Am I the Asshole, facts, and true crime. So I'm kind of focusing on that now. Also, I was thinking about doing true crime. So as someone commented, they liked that I did it on a heist last time and not just murder and kidnap. So if I ask AI for kind of non-heist kind of mysteries or whatever, it will give me ones, and then I can research on that in myself. That's really helpful, just to give me ideas and to give me questions and all that. So really like AI, and yeah, I think they also said drug heists and like drug scandals. not sure exactly what it's called, but I might do one like that. And yeah, it's kind of not peace. It's kind of good when not someone dies necessarily. Like, you know, obviously heists are, you don't want them to happen. You don't want people to steal things, but at least no one died, I guess. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something from it. I don't know if it was that informative, but it's just, you know, I think I've gotten a few comments, like, or at least one comment recently that said something like, oh, I hope you, like, blow up, or I hope you get recognition or all this, because I really like your videos and whatever else. But I'm like, you know what, I'm doing really well for a start channel, and I'm not exactly sure what's normal, but it's not to the stage where I blew up like crazy, but it's not to the stage where it's really, really slow. Like, I get at least 10 subscribers a day now or something. Sometimes I get like at least 60 watch time hours a day, which is really good. And like, I'm on track for getting monetization or whatever in like 4 months, or maybe 4 more months, or like half a year. I don't really know. Half a year total, I mean. I'm not sure exactly. And it's going up and up, so the growth rate is increasing as well. But that's good, you know. Some people take years to do that, you know. So YouTube is a long game as well. If you blow up immediately, maybe, you know, it won't continue, who knows. But I'm just really thankful, really thankful. And everyone that's watching means so much to me. If I can help relax you or help you sleep, whatever, it's meaningful to me. And yeah, if you have any ideas, keep them coming my way, because yeah, it's hard to think of all the things. I kind of wanted a different mic at first, but I actually quite like this. My dad let me borrow this. Basically, I'm just using all the stuff to do it. Like, I use this camera, I use this, but he doesn't mind that much. Well, he doesn't really use this stuff anyway. The tripod, I think he originally got the tripod so I could use it. He hasn't used it at all, I think. But thank you so much. And yeah, I was originally going to get a new microphone actually for my birthday, like a Yeti or something. And I know someone, it's actually funny, someone commented like, I like that you don't use the Yeti. I was going to get one. I didn't like the microphone I was using the first few videos, but then what happened was, it was my birthday, and I think it's because I was talking about getting a new mic that my dad was like, you know, I have this recorder. And I was like, oh, okay. And I tried it out and I really like it, so I'm really using it for now. And if I get another mic, I might still use this if my dad lets me. He doesn't use it, but he might want it back, you never know. Like, it's good quality. It might be more expensive than the Yeti, is it anyway? I don't know. Not that it's about that, but either way, I just didn't know he had this. But anyway, because it's almost like a USB mic that was like probably like 25. Hope it's useful. If any questions about any of this, let me know. I'm kind of watching these kind of videos, but they're not too popular, or at least a lot of them that are out there are like what I made, like money wise my first month on YouTube monetized, or my first year or whatever. But I can't do that because I'm not monetized yet. But if I am monetized, I might do it. But then again, I heard that YouTube don't like those kind of videos. I'm not sure if they like these ones or not, because, you know, it's meant to be kind of a secret what people learn on YouTube. But either way, but of course people are curious. Either way, it's interesting to see, like, if you don't have a channel, you probably don't have this whole YouTube studio set up and all of this. So it's interesting to see what actually happens kind of behind the scenes a little bit. But yeah, thank you so much for all the support so far. I appreciate every single one of your comments, whether it be just positive or, you know, some constructive criticism, as long as it's phrased nicely, of course I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Of course, no need to be rude, and you know, rude, just plain out rude. But constructive criticism phrased nicely, of course, can be done. I mean, you don't need to keep saying the same things, I guess, unless it's very apparent or noticeable to you. Like, I know that I talk a bit fast now. You don't need to keep saying it, you know. I understand that. Maybe that's just me, you know. Maybe I'm not the right fit for you if I talk too fast for you, or just watch a different video. But yeah, the other thing was, I don't really know what the other thing was. Thanks. Oh, I appreciate every single comment, and I try to reply to every single Sasa, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one.